Name is Vineet Tyagi, and I represent Insulation Energy Private Limited. We are basically a solar module manufacturer. Started our journey in April this year. Though we are into solars for almost 2 years, we own solar plants in Ujjain as well as in Bikaner. But in manufacturing, we have recently ventured around 6 months back. So, since morning, we have been discussing many challenges. We have discussed many opportunities about solar. We had a lot of discussion from EPC players, developers, and a few of the presentation from module manufacturers like Sonali, and in the morning from Goldie Green. So I will be talking about the opportunities, challenges in the solar, which we have been discussing since morning, but from the point of view of a manufacturers. So I will be looking at the things from my perspective. So I have structured my presentation into 3 parts. First part, I will take you through a brief introduction about insulation energy. Then we'll discuss about the opportunities and the current scenario in the solar. Then I'll try to link up these opportunities with the challenges what we are facing today. And finally, we will wrap it up with the remedial measures. So this is the plant what we have set up near Jaipur. It's a 60 megawatt fully automatic facility on the outskirts of the Jaipur, and first of its kind in Rajasthan. And as you can see, with least manual intervention and continuous automatic process, we have automatic stringers, pre and post inline EL testers. That means you get EL tester before lamination and after lamination. This is very much essential in case of detecting any kind of minute cracks which cannot be seen through the naked eyes, or maybe even the current losses also. After that, we have automatic framing machines for seamless framing. And finally, AAA class sun simulator. This is a schematic diagram of our line, which has been sourced from Jinshan, China, right from the glass loading and to the end. Everything is being handled by the robotic machines. It's purely untouched by the hand. These are the actual production facilities photographs you can see. Now I'll take you the key challenges what we are facing right now. Before that, I'll take you just once again through these statistics which we have been discussing since morning. The cumulatively solar installations have crossed 15 gigawatt, which we all are proud of. Since last 2 years only, the things have picked up. In the current year, by the end of July, by the end of August, we have done around 6 gigawatt. And in rooftop, we have already crossed 1 gigawatt. And we hope to close this year by another 10 gigawatt. So by the end of this year, we hope to cross a figure of around 20 gigawatt. Out of this, 850 megawatt is going to be installed through rooftop during this year. With this, the renewable contribution to the total installed capacity of India, which is more than 300 gigawatt right now, is almost 18%, with solar contributing to almost around 5% to this. The solar installations forecasted for the next year is around 8 gigawatt, though as per national solar missions, we need to achieve around 100 gigawatt by 2022. That means we need to touch a figure of almost around 20 gigawatt every year. The best part is solar has accounted for 35% of the new capacity additions in 2017 of all the capacity additions through all the energy sources. The good thing is the MNRE, to our benefit, to the benefit of domestic manufacturer, has proposed the development of 7.5 gigawatt of solar plants using domestic content. The sad part is this DCR content is going to end in December 2017 as per the WTO ruling. Then since morning, we have been talking about the solar tariff crossing the 2.5 barrier benchmark. So what is the significance of this, basically? When we talk of 15 gigawatt installations every year, we talk of till 2022, 20 gigawatt installations, we see a lot of opportunities, a lot of things happening in the solar sector. But there is another side to it. from a manufacturer perspective, when we think, the cheap imports are harming us. So instead of the domestic manufacturer reaping the benefits, or the Indian national reaping the benefits, the things have been, or the advantages have gone to other players. So solar imports worth $3 billion have been imported from the in the financial year 2016 and 17. More than 90% of these were imported. 85% was accounted by the China, and domestic module manufacturer had a share of less than 10%. Chinese panel typically cost 10 to 20% less than Indian panels, riding on cheap Chinese government subsidies. So in the morning when we discuss that Indian manufacturers, they don't have the capacity to match the kind of installation we are having, say roughly around 10 gigawatt or maybe 15 gigawatts or 20 gigawatts in the coming years. We are sitting on a capacity of around 8 gigawatts right now, as of module manufacturers I'm talking, with an operational capacity of around 5.5 gigawatts. So in terms of the opportunity, we have a scope further for adding another 5 to 10 megawatts if we are going to do everything on our own, since 90% or maybe 85% is coming from China alone. So these kind of capacity, if you are looking at, requires a lot of efforts, a lot of funds, a lot of policy changes. So currently, the basic problem which manufacturers are facing is the GST implications. GST, which was implemented in the month of July, as you are aware, in most of the states earlier, the solar were exempted, solar module in particular. Now it has been taxed at 5%. And if I look into solar as a whole, it varies from 5 to 28%. The major raw material which are used in panel productions are taxed at 18%, while the panel as a whole attracts only the 5%. So, which means more than 200 crores of input tax credits are pending with the government, resulting in high working capital costs. So solar industry, particularly if you look at the manufacturers, module manufacturer in particular, that much amount of money is already blocked with the government. And since the government has raised the limit for filing GST to December, things are only going to get worse. That means manufacturers are incurring high inventory carry cost, high working capital costs, which are ultimately going to pass on to the customer. So GST is one such applications. Then within this solar also, we have seen same components which are used for different applications attract different slabs. For example, battery and inverters, if they are built or if they are clubbed with solar products, say module and all, they attract 5%. But on their own, if they sell alone, they attract 28% or maybe 18% for the inverters. So that anomaly has to be settled and addressed. Then on top of it, we have BIS norms coming. The ministry, in its notification, has made BIS Act compulsory from 1st of January. Earlier, it was decided to implement the order from September 2018, since this was launched in 2017. So 1 year grace period was given to switch over to BIS norm and to get the BIS, your product BIS registers. So within a gap of, say, 1 and 2 months, the manufacturer has to get his product BIS approved. After 1st of January, they cannot sell their product. So already, we have our products certified through IEC, TUV, UL, many other certifications which are required, in some cases MNRE or maybe through NICE and all. Then within a gap of 2 months, you are shifting to another norms. So there is no clarity from the government in terms of the guidelines which clearly differentiate the basic conditions which are different from IEC and which are there in BIS. So there are no clear-cut guidelines or the draft lines which mention the difference between the two. If at all they are there, there are no benefits which are mentioned which will accrue to the manufacturers if we go on for BIS registration. Thirdly, these IEC certificates and all, each manufacturer spent lakh of rupees on them, and they are valid for 5 years. So suddenly, within a gap of 2 months, they all will become invalid. So the manufacturer has to again go to the government, again get the whole process done again, and just within a 2 years, if the people are carrying the inventory, it becomes useless after December 31st. So that is the problem again. So thirdly, things are piling on, one after another. First, we started with GST, then BIS norms, then empty dumping duty is already in the pipeline. Though developers and everybody in the morning, I saw they were cribbing about it. There are two perspectives to it. Earlier also in 2014, anti-dumping duty was investigated by DGAD, but it was rejected finally by the finance ministry. So this time again, the investigation has been initiated. It will take around a year to come out with some preliminary investigations and to come out with some duties if at all government decides to go for it. Then after that, it's on the discretion of the finance ministry to accept the recommendation of the commerce ministry. So for during this transition period, market again will be in the doldrums. So final rule will be a tough balancing act between creating a market for domestic manufacturers and without killing a demand for solar power, so that it's a win-win situation for each and everybody. So to wrap up, since the time is running short, I'll just like to mention the remedial measures which can take care of everybody in interest. So imposition of anti-dumping duties or safeguard duties against cheap imports will go a long way in helping the domestic manufacturers. Then, if the government really interested in setting up the domestic manufacturing base, they need to have some special specific package for setting up large domestic manufacturing base, since there is a huge gap between demand and supply. Though we have incentive policies like SIP and MSIP, but it's very cumbersome and not in a transparent manner and not easily implemented. No doubt GST and VS norms are good for the industry, but smooth implementation is very much necessary so that there is no transitional problems. And to top of it, research and development, which is very much essential, because we have been talking about decreasing the cost, increasing the operational efficiencies and everything. Until and unless we put a lot of funds in research and development for increasing the efficiency or maybe developing a new products, nothing can be done, or maybe we cannot go a long way. So with this, I close my presentation. Thanks for hearing.